Mesh has now been recognised by the government as a project of national significance. What does that actually mean in practical terms?
Well, it's a recognition of the project being able to make a play a critical role in UK's energy transition, and as described, one of the key pillars of the UK's energy transition going forward. The priorities are developing renewable wind generating capacity, and not far behind that is storage solutions for the reasons we've already discussed. Mesh as a long duration energy storage solution is a large scale facility capable of storing energy for long durations of time, so multi-day storage that can then be dispatched into the UK grid when the wind's not blowing.
The S35 planning approval sounds like a major milestone. How does it streamline development and speed up delivery?
So what happens with Section 35 designation as a project of national significance is that the project runs through a particular planning approval process now. And it's essentially the various components of the MESH project are all umbrellaed under a single planning approval process and a development consent order. And the idea behind that is it streamlines nationally significant projects to run through such a process, so it works more smoothly to deliver important projects for the country.
You've said MESH could help capture wasted wind power. How will that work, and what difference could it make to consumers' bills?
Well, so as I've already sort of partially described, the cost to consumers of curtailed wind is currently running at £1 billion a year. The government's own forecasts of curtailment or constraint costs are forecast to increase by 2030 to up to £6 billion to £8 billion. And all of that just gets passed on to the consumers' bills. So any project or facility that enables that wasted wind power to be harnessed and reused will be for the benefit of consumers and will be able to reduce their electricity bills.
MESH combines gas, hydrogen and compressed air storage. Can you explain how that integrated system works and why it's important?
Yeah, so the important aspect here is our principal sort of arm of our energy storage system, long duration energy storage system, is a compressed air system. And the benefit of that and the way we're going about it is that we can do it at scale, and we can also do it in a repeatable manner. And so we can offer up long duration dispatchable periods of supply from this system because we can store at scale. So we're looking at multi-days. Now, if you compare that, say, for example, with battery energy storage systems as a means of storing electricity, the UK average storage duration from battery energy storage systems is 1.4 hours. And that comes also with a capital cost now. So we think we can deliver multi-day storage at a competitive cost, say in comparison to battery energy storage as a solution. And for example, solutions such as pumped hydro.